Hi everyone, I'm Satya Sekar, a developer evangelist with Salesforce. In this quick tech, I'll show you how to examine and debug your Apex code effectively with the Apex Replay Debugger. There are other ways to debug your Apex code. One is to use the system.debug statements and look into the debug logs. Another is to use the interactive debugger sessions, which are only available to the paid ops. My favorite is Apex Replay Debugger, which is free and it is easy to set up on the VS Code. Let's see how it works. We can start working with Apex Replay Debugger by turning on debug logs. Let's do that from VS Code using the command palette. Type SFDX replay and select SFDX turn on Apex debug log for replay debugger. Once it starts successfully, you can see recording detailed logs in the status bar and it shows how long will it continue. If needed, you can turn it on again after the expiry time. Now let us run a test to generate a debug log. We will generate debug log for a class named ContactController, which we will debug later. Alternatively, you can also use anonymous Apex to generate the debug logs. Next, we'll open the command palette and type getApex and select SFDX getApex debug logs. This will get a list of recently generated debug logs. We'll choose the latest log that we have generated. Let us double click on the tab so that this log file is pinned here. If you close the log file by mistake, don't worry. You can find all the downloaded log files in .sfdx/tools/debug/logs folder. You can download multiple debug logs and replay them with the debugger to compare different scenarios. Let's debug some code. Here we are in ContactController class. It has some methods that get contact information. Let's debug the findContacts method and trace the values using the debug log that we have generated. We'll set a breakpoint here by clicking on the left side of this line. Next, select the debug log file and click anywhere on the page. You can right-click now and select Launch Apex Replay Debugger with the current file. You can see a debugging toolbar pop up at the top. Click on the play button. It starts running and stops at the breakpoint. If not already opened, you can click on the bug icon in the activity bar to open the debugger view. Here, you can see variables, the call stack, breakpoints and checkpoints. The things that you would expect from any debugger. Not only that, you can also hover over the properties to see the current value. Next, let's step over. You can also now see the key property value. You can also directly invoke the debugger from the debug view using the launch configuration for the replay debugger. Let us now set up a launch configuration. Click the drop down on the top left and select add configuration. If you don't see the drop down, you can see a link, create a launch.json file. You can click it. Next, select the Apex Replay Debugger as your environment. It adds the launch configuration to your launch.json file. If the file is not existing, it creates the launch.json file for you and adds the configuration to it. Now, you can click Start Debugging button in the launch view and select a log file to launch the debugger. You can now click the play button in the pop-up debugging toolbar and continue debugging. You might also want to take a look at some of the considerations and any known issues mentioned in the Salesforce extensions documentation. For instance, you can replay only one debug log at a time. Apex Replay Debugger is an awesome tool and it plays back debug logs. You can examine the same execution multiple times to debug without worrying about the state of the org changing. Thanks for watching. If you learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.